Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. Friends, today we will be talking about tuberculosis, pulmonary tuberculosis. We have made a lot of videos, so if you want to find something about health and healthcare, just type your topic and Dr. Education on YouTube and you'll find a video. So let's talk about tuberculosis, how it happens and everything you need to know about it.
The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever.
See, pulmonary tuberculosis, TB, is a contagious bacterial infection that involves your lungs and it can also spread to other organs. You have to remember. This is caused by a bacteria which is called Mycobacterium tuberculosis, M. tuberculosis, and it is very contagious. This means that the bacteria can easily spread from one infected person to another, right? Someone else. And you can get tuberculosis by just breathing in the air droplets from the cough of or a sneeze of an infected person. This results in an infection which will lead to tuberculosis, which will lead to primary TB. Primary, that means there was the first time the bacteria entered your body. Most people actually recover from primary TB infection without any further evidence of the disease. That means the infection can be killed off by your own immunity. Many times this is the thing which happens, but the infection may stay inactive, dormant for years, and in some people it can become active again over time, reactivation, right? So most people who develop a symptom of this TB first became infected in the past, and in some cases the disease actually becomes active within the week after the primary infection. So there are some categories of people who are at higher risk of active tuberculosis or reactive tuberculosis. You have to understand, active tuberculosis means which have symptoms of TB. Just entering of the bacteria in your body does not mean you'll get TB. Every single person in a developing country will have had an exposure with the tuberculosis bacteria at least once in their life, right? Not everybody has tuberculosis. So there are some risk people who will have active tuberculosis or an reactivation of dormant tuberculosis very easily. These are older adults, old people, small infants basically, people with weakened immune system, like people who have HIV, AIDS, who are diabetic, who are on chemotherapy for cancers or any medicine which weakens the immune system, right? Your risk of catching tuberculosis increases if you are around a person who has TB. If you live in a crowded, unclean living condition, or if you have poor nutrition, because you won't be able to fight off the bacteria, right? Obviously, if there are increased number of HIV infections in the population, if there are so many homeless people, there are poor environment, there is poor nutrition all around you, if there is presence of drug abuse, then these factors actually lead to dissemination of this disease easily, and many people will come up with this kind of a problem and there will be drug resistance, so treating them will be a challenge. But finally, what happens when you actually have this bacteria inside your body? The primary stage of tuberculosis symptoms, they do not actually happen. So in the primary stage, symptoms won't happen, right? But the symptoms may happen afterwards in pulmonary tuberculosis. What will happen if the person will have breathing difficulty? They will have cough, they can have chest pain, cough with mucus, they can cough up blood, they might have excessive sweating, particularly in night. That is what we call evening rise of temperature in the body, right? Evening fever, then fatigue fever, weight loss, wheezing can happen. These all things can happen, right? So if a person comes up with all these symptoms with cough, persistent cough, you have to test for tuberculosis. So what are the tests? After a physical examination, in which the doctor will check for clubbing. Clubbing in fingers is or toes is a sign of advanced disease, where improper supply of blood, oxygen, comes to the digits, and the digits, the nails actually swell like that. It becomes clubbed fingers, right? Clubbed nails. Then the swollen or tender lymph nodes can be found in the neck or the inguinal regions in many areas, right? Fluid can be seen around the lung in x-rays also, and sometimes crackling sounds can be heard in the lungs. But the actual tests which actually prove that you have tuberculosis, they include either a chest x-ray, a CT scan. Sometimes bronchoscopy is done, in which we use a scope to actually view your airways from inside. We put a small tube with a camera inside your airways, right? Then there are sputum tests, sputum examination. At least 3 sputum examination has to be done on different days, right? And first sputum of the day has to be taken, and culture as well as staining of the sputum has to be done. Then interferon gamma release blood tests, such as TB gold test, can be done for that. Then sometimes, if there is actually fluid in the lungs, then fluid can be aspirated out. This is called thoracocentesis, and that can be sent for testing. Then skin test can be done, tuberculin skin test, or very rarely you might need a biopsy of the affected tissue, right? Whatever is affected, not necessarily lung will be affected, other tissues can be affected. So treatment, the goal of the treatment is to cure the infection, completely cure, so that the tuberculosis bacteria does not actually remain dormant and the possibility of reactivation is zero, right? That's why it's difficult, right? So active pulmonary tuberculosis is treated with a combination of many medicines. Usually there are 4 medicines, 4 antibiotics, and the person takes these medicines until the lab test shows that which medicines works best, or the tubercular bacteria is gone from wherever it was found in the lung, right? You may need to take many different pills at different times of the day for 6 months or longer, and it is very important for you to take the pills the way your doctor has instructed. When people do not take their medicines, TB medicines, like they are supposed to, the infection can become much more difficult to treat, and even tuberculosis bacteria can become resistant to those medicines. This means that these medicines will no longer work in any other person because of your silly mistake. So if you have this disease, you have to make sure to follow the regime properly, right? So if a person is not taking all the medicines as directed, a doctor may need to watch the person take the prescribed medicine in front of his eyes. This approach is called directly observed therapy. In this case, the medicine may be given 2 to 3 times a week, right? This is the intensity of that, the severity of the disease, right? So you may need to stay at home or be admitted to a hospital for 2 to 4 weeks to avoid spreading of the disease to others until you are no longer contagious, if you have contagious tuberculosis, right? So your doctor is required by the law to report if you have a tubercular illness to the local health authorities, right? This is also a part. So it is very important that you and your doctor should team up together, understand the disease, and then only you can receive the best treatment, best care possible. There are so many propagandas, so many support groups present. We can help you understand the disease better. See, outcome symptoms often improve in 2 to 3 weeks after starting the treatment. So it's just about properly taking medicines. A chest x-ray will not show this improvement until at least a month or so, right? And quite frankly, the outlook, it is excellent if pulmonary tuberculosis is diagnosed early and effective treatment is started very quickly. It is 100% curable. So all you need to do is get diagnosed early and take proper treatment, right? If you don't do that, then possibly complication can happen, and complications can cause permanent lung damage, right? If you don't go early for testing, it can also spread to other parts of the body, and medicines can also have a side effects. Yes, so that's why you need to go back and recheck regularly for any side effects, like changes in vision, for any rash, liver disease, liver inflammation. You might have a changed color of your urine also, of even brown colored tears can come. That is also a complication, a side effect of the medicine. Therefore, a vision test is done before the start of the treatment so that your doctor can monitor the changes in your eyes health also, right? So if you have any, if you think you have been exposed to TB, if you develop any symptom of tuberculosis, or if you actually show symptom despite of the treatment, then you should again go to a pulmonologist, a chest physician. And remember, tuberculosis is curable, but you need to take efforts for that. Is it preventable? See, even in those who have been exposed to an infected person, you know, skin testing for tuberculosis is used. Skin testing for tuberculosis is used in high-risk population, so that we know that you have been exposed to tuberculosis, such as like in healthcare workers, we can see that. So if your skin test is positive, it was a past infection, right? People who have been exposed to tuberculosis should have a skin test as soon as possible, and then have a follow-up test at a later date if the first test is negative, right? That is also important thing. And a positive skin test means that you have come in contact with tubercular bacteria, but it does not mean that you have an active TB or you are contagious, right? So you don't have to worry about it, right? But if you really want to contain the disease, prompt treatment is very important whenever you find an active tuberculosis patient, right? So this is very, very important. And remember, there is a vaccine, BCG vaccine. People who have had that vaccine at birth may still be skin tested for tuberculosis, right? For this, you need to discuss the test result with your doctor, whether it is positive or not, right? Remember that. So this is all about the information which you need about pulmonary tuberculosis, TB. I hope this was helpful. Don't forget to share this and let me know your views. Give a big thumbs up. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected. Stay healthy.